مرحبا, welcome to this new Arabic Palestinian dialect lesson with me, Maha. Today I'm going to teach you a very, very important verb conjugation in the past, which is the verb to go. I'm going to teach you exactly how to use it in the past, and we're going to create sentences with it in order for us to improve our situational Arabic, or using the Arabic that we learn in class into situations and being able to speak it eventually. Let's begin. So the verb to go in Palestinian Arabic, it's not the verb ذهبه, which is found in the standard Arabic. It's the verb راح. راح, that's the verb. I'm going to write everything on board today. Alhamdulillah, I have a whiteboard that I've been using for my online Arabic courses. If you still don't know, I'm holding online Arabic courses because of the virus situation. I had to cancel my courses in the Holy Land, and I had to come up with the idea of holding online Arabic courses. I've been holding them since late March, and alhamdulillah, they are going fantastic. New students every week are coming, and the students who started are continuing and are becoming better and better in Arabic. I have taught this, for example, the verb to go in my Palestinian dialect class about week two, like after 1 week of them starting. So this is pretty advanced, but yet it is teachable, and it's very, very useful, because I don't like to teach the grammar that you don't use. Again, I'm repetitive, but I like to teach the words or situations or expressions that you would really use in a language you're learning. راح is the verb to go. This is how we write it for people who are still struggling with the Latin letters, with the Arabic letters. I hope you are not. But in any case, I will write also everything in the Latin transcription of the verb. Because this is a verb conjugation, I want you to focus on how we conjugate any verb in the past tense. Now, I chose a very difficult verb. Why? Every verb that has at least one of its three root letters vowel, and راح has a vowel, it's an A here in the middle. This vowel is problematic when it comes to the conjugation. Why? The vowels change. They change into another vowel. So I don't say راحت, I say رحت. Let's see it together. What happens in particular with the verb to go? I will move quickly, because I guess you are an advanced Palestinian, or you've been acquainted with the Palestinian dialect before, or at least the standard Arabic conjugation, and you know what happens in the past tense. But in short, the past tense conjugation in Arabic in general, or in the Palestinian dialect in particular, changes the ending. If I want to say I went, I change something, I add some letters at the ending. If I say you went, I change those letters in the ending. So you will see that we focus more on the suffixes. So if I want to say I went, let me see where you can see. Okay, you can see here. We say Ana rahat. What happens to the vowel A is it becomes ru. And what we add is T. Sometimes people say rahat to simplify their lives by adding the consonant H and consonant T, they move it a little bit with the E. So rohit or rohit, this is how we say I went. I'm going to write it here. I went. Ana rohit. I went. Ana rohit. Inti, you, male. Inti, the same thing. Inti rohit, same thing. I went. Ana rohit. You went, انت رحت. If you're a female and you went somewhere, we say انت رحتي. There's always a stop, not only with the verb راح, there's always a stop with you female. We divide the syllables of the verb in order to simplify our pronunciation. We don't say رحتي, we say رحتي. أكلتي. رجعتي. أخد. T, bus, T. These all are verbs that I'm showing you. I know you don't know the majority of them, but just to give you the idea that with you, we have to, in order to simplify our pronunciation, to cut between the sections of the verb. Na rohiti, rohti. So what happens? Rohti. Now, what do we add is this. I do the action, I always add it, no matter what verb it is, guys. Whatever verb you want to take, six-letter verb, a regular derivative verb, as many vowels as you want. If I do it in the past, it ends with it. Ana akalit, I ate. Ana ruhit, I went. أنا مشيت I walked أنا درست I studied أنا سبحت I swam whatever verb that's coming to my mind if I conjugate it in the past it ends with it remember this and this will save your lives so these rules in blue are the rules that you need to stick with them this is the conjugation rule in the dialect okay so أنا رحت you male رحت you female we add T these are my rules these that we add to each verb conjugation whatever verb again we're talking about so انت رحتي then we want to say he went guys is always the original or the infinitive verb so it's exactly like the infinitive verb راح هو راح he went هو راح I don't add anything with she guys She is exactly the infinitive, but adding at the ending. So راح becomes راحت. 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 This hat, what is this at? It's the rule that we add to any verb, not only to the verb she went, راحت. Now we have two more conjugations, no, three more. We have we went. You all went and they all went. I don't have any more space in my whiteboard. That's why I'm going to erase something and then I will rewrite them for you. So let's, before we erase, let's recap. Ana rohit, I went. Inti rohit, you went. Inti rohti, remember, rohti. Huwa rah, he went. Hiyi rahat, she went. Hiyi rahat. I'm treating you as if I was in my online normal course. I'm not going to edit the videos. I'm gonna give them to you the way they are. Maybe cut the unimportant things that I might end up saying. Okay, so I'm now rohit, rohit, rohti. Then هو راح, هي راحت. Now we, احنا we say, I hope you see it, yes. روح. Na. So what we end up adding, guys, is this na. We say ruh na to any verb. Believe me, when I say it, any verb, and we will see it later. You add na, then we did it in the past. Ruhna. Into all of you, we say ruh tu. Ruh tu. So we add an u at the ending. Ruh tu. Here we go. Now. This is called urban Palestinian dialect or urban Shami dialect. There's something called sub-dialect. In these sub-dialects, which means like if you are from a city rather than from a village, you might end up like changing slight and simple things, not all verb conjugation. And what I'm going to add here is that in the sub-dialect, like in some cities like Ramallah or maybe in the West Bank, or in the Shami dialect in general, in some villages, there's something called Falahi dialect, which is the rural Palestinian dialect and not the urban Palestinian dialect. This is something you don't need to focus on. Focus on the normal dialect and then the small varieties. They end up happening also between us Arabs. If I'm from Haifa, the city, I speak different than from Akka, the other city that is only like 20 minutes away. Okay, not speak totally different, but some things change. And might change and you have to choose if you want to stick with the normal rule or the sub-dialect. So why all this thing? I'm saying it because I want to tell you that if you went in some areas in the West Bank, you might say into rohtum. So ending a verb, you did it, all of you, instead of tu, you can also find an M here at the ending. So it would become like this, rohtum. And it's acceptable if you want to stick with ruhtu without pronouncing the M is still the urban Palestinian dialect and it's totally fine. Okay, I will use ruhtu, but I will always remind you of some varieties that you might end up having or facing in Palestinian dialect. So into ruhtu, all of you went and they, what happens to they? They goes back to the original, which is the base form rah. And we add an u at the ending. Hinni ra
So, راحوا. راح is the verb. What we add is u. U works with all verbs.
راحوا, they went. أكلوا, they ate. أخذوا, they took. رجعوا, they came back. ناموا, they slept. You see, everything is ending with u. Whatever verb I'm choosing, it ends with u because they did the action. Now, this is a verb conjugation, guys. It's as easy as this. And I chose a very difficult verb. I chose a verb that contains a vowel. So if I choose a verb that doesn't contain vowels, and we will see in the following lessons, you will see that it's even easier than this. Let's go back to recap quickly to try to memorize the conjugation and to create some sentences. So I will write only Latin letters for now, just for making the lesson quick. Ana rohit. Ana is I. You male, inti rohit. Again, ana rohit, inti rohit. You went. Oops, I should have written inti. So inti, which means you female, inti roh, what? Stop. Ti. Stop it, or like separate it. Inti rohti. Ana rohit, inti rohit, inti female, rohti. This inti in the pronoun, it means you, but it means you female, and it's the same pronoun for you male. We still say inti and inti. In some sub-dialects, they say inta and inti. Inta is you male, and inti is you female. Again, this is optional. In my dialect, I say inti if you are Muhammad, and I say inti if you are Maria. Okay? So, ana rohit, inti rohit, inti rohti. Huwe, which means he. Rah, we remember that we put nothing to the verb. He, which means she. Rahat, remember we add at to the rule. Ihna. Ihna means we. Ruhna. We go back to ruh, 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 and we add na, the ending. Into, all of you. Ruh. And hinni, which means they, all of them. Rahu. Also here, I want to mention something. Some Palestinian dialect, in order to say they, you would say humme instead of hinni. It's acceptable both. Humme and hinni, they mean they. Huwe is he. He is she. Ihna is we. Into is all of you. You all. So this is the list of verb conjugations, guys. These are our pronouns. This is the verb rah, which means to go. And these are the endings for any verb. Rohit, rohit, rohti, nothing, rah, rahat, rohna, rohtu, and rahu. In order to make this lesson complete, I will write it again one more time in Arabic. Ana rohit, inti rohit, inti female rohti. So repeat it after me. This is also good. Repetition is key. Huwe rah, he went. Hiye rahat. Ihna rohna, we went. Into rohtu, all of you. Rohtu and hinni rahu, they went. Guys, this is the verb conjugation of the verb to go in Palestinian Arabic, in Jordanian Arabic, in Lebanese and in Syrian Arabic. This is the urban dialect spoken in all these four countries, understood by the majority of Arabs. And usually the conjugation is similar in all Arabic dialects, except for the Maghribi dialect, which is a little bit more distant than the Levant, the dialects of the Levant area. So this is the verb conjugation. I hope you like it. And what is going to happen now is we're going to create sentences and see where we use the verb or how we use the verb rahit. I don't want to make this lesson too long, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach you something new in grammar. I'm going to create a couple of sentences, and I'm going to give you some homework to create. And I want to see how you create the homework, if you understood the lesson or not. Remember, we're speaking Palestinian Arabic.